My wife's been telling me to try to stay more positive. I think this album is helping. Tranquilo. Shine. I'm Nicholas Stock from The Vinyl Herd. We've been doing some more vinyl-specific content, but what we haven't done is any specific record reviews. And I want to start off that trend with my review of the recently released album, Brightside, by the Lumineers. The Lumineers are a Colorado-based band who found national acclaim with their folk pop hit, Hey Ho. Now a more mature Wesley Schultz and Jeremiah Frates find themselves writing music for a world that struggles to emerge from the ravages of a pandemic. Rather than be negative about it, they chose to take on a positive tone, with the album title Brightside being a very appropriate title, with the overall message being, hey, we are going to get through this. Clocking in at just over 30 minutes, Brightside continues a sound and style that is easily identifiable as the Lumineers, but utterly new through the use of electronic instrumentation and solid production work. Brightside was produced by longtime collaborator Simon Felice and engineered by David Barron over two sessions in the winter and spring of 2021. With a total of just 9 songs, I felt it would be appropriate to speak a little about each in this review. Stranded in the bed, you were listening to the dark side of the moon. I could barely see your eyes. The album opens with the title track, which sounds a lot like Our Hero Is Lost, despite their choice to be the bright side. I was stranded on the bed, you were listening to the dark side of the moon. Sounds a lot like how me and a lot of my vinyl friends spent much of quarantine. It becomes very apparent that that's what this album is about, right? It's about, you know, how these two individuals are, you know, coming out of a pandemic. And I think that that's what's so amazing about this record. AM Radio was the second single off the album after Brightside, and it feels like a love song, but there seems to be more to it. Where we are, I don't know where we are, but it will be okay. Where we are, I don't know where we are, but it will be okay. Where We Are is a musical Polaroid of the day-to-day trauma that people have endured over the last few years. Schultz has commented that this song is using a car accident he experienced as a metaphor for what we are going through now as a society. But rather than dwell in the pain, the song says, it will be okay. Calling out your name, staring at the ceiling, fan of feet and far away, leaning on the reasons like it wasn't even fair. What was I? Driving in the rain. What was I? Calling out your name. What was that? Driving in the rain. What was that? Calling out your name. To me, this whole sporadic, what was that, in the song itself, it's like a personal experience that I had many times throughout the pandemic, where you're just like, you cannot focus, your brain is scattered, and it's like, what was that? You can't really focus. And to me, like, that's why this album continues to just hit home, over and over again. Birthday is a modern spin on the old Birthday song, but you know, where the balloons are like kind of deflated, you know? It's the hook and bass line are a blatant nod to the Beatles song of the same name, but it truly feels like a birthday song for our times, right? Like, it's not as enthusiastic as, you know, the regular Happy Birthday song. Big Shot was the third single from Brightside, and to me, this feels like a mournful song about what could have been the last couple of years. It's also about self-reflection and about crushing the ego a bit as we move into the new. We've had time the last couple of years to sit down with our own thoughts and sort of reflect about whether or not we are as big as our ego sort of thinks we are. Much of the new album pays tribute sonically to the heroes of both Freights and Schultz, including Never Really Me, which is a nod to Springsteen and the classic rock that was part of their upbringing in New Jersey. I think it's pretty obvious if you listen to that song that there's some Springsteen at the root of it. Let's listen to a little bit of Roller Coaster, which is the next track off the album. That's perhaps the most beautiful and heartfelt song. It's the most direct comment by the Lumineers about the COVID pandemic specifically. I think if you listen to what they're talking about, they're talking about now, and they're talking about what people are going through. And I think that's why this album raises above it's just sort of your regular output. I mean, they really are creating art that is reflective of what's happening right now in our world.
Sitting on a roller coaster, holding on for dear life. Sitting on a roller coaster, holding on for dear life. I know what is what, I know who you are. I know what is already gone.
And I think that makes it more powerful. Remington paints a scene of an uncertain future with lines like, I'm waiting on the sun tonight. It's like, we're all kind of waiting on that sun. You know, we're all waiting for this to be over. You know, it doesn't matter what your politics are, it doesn't matter where you're from, what your background is, you're done with it. And we all are. And that's, again, where it's really easy to fall into the negative and fall into the sort of like, woe is me. But that's why this album, you know, even though it has this sort of ambiguous ending that we're talking about right now, it's still telling you not to dwell in the negative, not to dwell in the, you know, to focus on the bright side. So the last song does come back to, it's called Reprise, and it returns to the opening track. And again, it sort of leaves the final outcome of where we are or what's going on to the listener. But if you've listened to the rest of the record, you can kind of take that sort of positive tone and take it as a lesson to try and stay positive, even though it's all going to shit, people. No, you know, there's a lot to be thankful for out there. You got your records, you got your, you know, you can still go home and play a record, you know? And I think that when you come into something like this and it has an effect on you, like this record has, I mean, I've been had this record playing on repeat at my house over and over again. My wife and I are just singing out the lyrics, and I think it's helping, you know? And so just to give a couple vinyl specific comments, the packaging and production on this record is fantastic. I specifically like the varied color vinyl releases. There's a bunch of limited pressings for both small indie stores as well as box stores and as well as online retailers. I personally ordered the sun bleached version directly from the band. Whenever you have the opportunity to order a record from the band directly, do it. It's like more than 5,000 streams on Spotify. Like, it's so helpful. It's one of the best things you can do for a band is buying merch directly from them. Do it. I think honestly though, the Orange Daybreak version was the most stunning. No issues with my copy as far as playback, and the mastering is top notch. I think it sounds great. You know, it's got this sort of, they've sonically mastered, you know, the Lumineers sound in a way that's, it's just very bright. And it's very approachable. So even if you're not a Lumineers fan, I would recommend this record. Yeah, I just like the album variations. I don't know. I like colored records. I like bright colored vinyl, and I think it's neat. So I'll just end this little vinyl review with this. Brightside is an honest and emotional look back on the pandemic and what we've experienced as a society as we tread these new and uncertain times. It is raw, it is real, but never dribbles into the negative. Rather, they tell us what we all really know, that it will be all right. It might not be how it was, and it might not be the same, but it will be okay. At times, this record feels like a warm hug that I know we all sorely need. At others, it's an empathetic look at the times and a chance for us all to take a step back pick stock, and move forward. What other choice do we have?